Welcome to a lesson on divisibility rules. The goal of this video is to determine if a given number is divisible by 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 8, 9, and 10. So let's go ahead and take a look at each rule. A number is divisible by 2 if it is even or ends in 0, 2, 4, 6, or 8. So for example, if we take a look at the number 512, and the number 431, we're only concerned about the last digit or the digit in the ones place value. 512 ends in 2, which means it's even and therefore it's divisible by 2. However, 431 ends in a 1, which means it's not even or that it's odd and it is not divisible by 2. A number is divisible by 4 if the last two digits are divisible by 4. If we take a look at 624 and 621, now we're only concerned about the last two digits. Here the 2 and the 4, and here the 2 and the 1. Well, 24 is divisible by 4, and therefore so is 624. But for our second number, 21 is not divisible by 4, and therefore 621 is not divisible by 4. Next, we'll take a look at the number 8. A number is divisible by 8 if the last three digits are divisible by 8. Now, I don't use this rule very often because it's often hard to tell whether a three-digit number is divisible by 8. However, if we did have a number, let's say 5088, the last three digits would be 088, and since 88 is divisible by 8, then so would 5088. Now let's take a look at the number 3. A number is divisible by 3 if the sum of the digits is divisible by 3. So for example, if we compare 813 and 724, we need to sum these digits, which means we'll take 8 plus 1 plus 3, that's going to give us 12. And over here we'd have 7 plus 2 plus 4, that's going to give us 13. So if this sum is divisible by 3, then so is the original number. And since 12 is divisible by 3, 813 is divisible by 3. However, over here we have 13. 13 is not divisible by 3, and therefore 724 is not divisible by 3. Next, a number is divisible by 6 if it is divisible by 2 and 3. So we already covered the rules for 2 and 3, so let's go ahead and give it a try using the numbers 372 and 362. Now what we have to do here is use the divisibility rule for 2 and 3 for both of these numbers. Notice that both of these numbers end in 2 and therefore are divisible by 2, but we also have to check divisibility by 3. So what we have to do now is sum these digits. Well, 3 plus 7 plus 2, that gives us 12. 12 is divisible by 3, therefore 372 is divisible by 3, so 372 is also divisible by 6. However, over here, 3 plus 6 plus 2, that would be equal to 11. 11 is not divisible by 3, and therefore 362 is not divisible by 3 or divisible by 6. For the number 9, a number is divisible by 9 if the sum of the digits is divisible by 9 as well. So if we take a look at 639 and 726, we again need to find the sum of the digits. 6 plus 3 plus 9, that would be 18. And since 18 is divisible by 9, so is 639. Here the sum would be 7 plus 2 plus 6, that would be 15. 15 is not divisible by 9, and therefore 726 is not divisible by 9. And we have two more rules to look at. A number is divisible by 10 if it ends in a 0. And this rule is pretty straightforward if we compare 5,820 and 5,624. This number ends in a 0 or has a 0 in the ones place value and therefore is divisible by 10. 5,624 does not end in a 0 and therefore is not divisible by 10. And then the last rule we're going to take a look at, a number is divisible by 5 if it ends in a 0 or a 5, or it has a 0 or a 5 in the ones place value. So if we take a look at 9,785 and 6,276, this number here is divisible by 5 because it ends in a 5 or a 0, and this number here is not divisible by 5 because it does not end in a 0 or a 5. Now let's go and take a look at a couple more problems. Here we want to determine if the given numbers are divisible by 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 8, 9, and 10. So now we'll go through all of these rules for an individual number. So let's go ahead and list these possible divisors. The rule for 2 is it has to be an even number or ends in a 0, 2, 4, 6, or 8, and it does. It ends in a 4, so it is divisible by 2. To determine if it's divisible by 3, we have to sum these digits. Well, 8 plus 0 plus 6 plus 4, that would give us 18. 18 is divisible by 3, and therefore so is the given number. And remember, if a number is divisible by 2 and 3, it's also divisible by 6. We can go ahead and circle 6. To determine if it's divisible by 4, we have to take a look at the last two digits, which would be 6 and 4, 64. And since 64 is divisible by 4, so is the given number. For 5, it has to end in a 0 or a 5, which it doesn't, so it's not divisible by 5. To determine if it's divisible by 8, we have to take a look at the last three digits, or 0, 6, 4. Well, and since 64 is divisible by 8, so is the given number. To test for 9, we have to find the sum of the digits, which we already did to determine if it was divisible by 3. The sum of the digits is 18. 18 is divisible by 9, therefore so is the given number. And then for 10, it has to end in a 0, which it doesn't. Therefore, it's not divisible by 10. So it's divisible by 2, 3, 4, 6, 8, and 9. Let's go ahead and try one more. Let's take a look at 270. Let's go ahead and list the possible divisors again. It ends in a 0 and therefore is even, so it's divisible by 2. And since it ends in a 0, we also know that it's divisible by 10 as well as 5. To determine if it's divisible by 3, we have to sum the digits. 2 plus 7 plus 0, that would be 9. And since 9 is divisible by 3, so is the given number. And since we have the sum of the digits, let's go ahead and test for 9. Since 9 is divisible by 9, so is the given number. To test for 4, we take a look at the last two digits. That would give us 70. 70 is not divisible by 4, and therefore the given number is not divisible by 4. To be divisible by 6, it has to be divisible by 2 and 3, which it is. And then lastly, to test for 8, we have to take a look at the last three digits, which is the entire number, 270. So this rule isn't very helpful, and 270 is not divisible by 8. Okay, that's going to do it for this video. I hope you found it helpful.